Hi, today's video is basically just going to be pretty much all the footage that I took whilst myself and my friend Erin went to the Cannes Film Festival, the 75th anniversary of the Cannes Film Festival. So I got the t-shirt to prove it and everything. Woo! Very exciting. It's one of the coolest things I've ever done. It's probably the coolest place I've ever been. And so, of course, I got loads of footage of the whole experience, and that's what this YouTube video is going to be.
This is us having just arrived in Cannes, walking around with our luggage and discovering the place for the first time.
Wait, this place is so cool. What the fuck?
The place we had to go to grab our badges for the festival was right beside a bunch of yachts. This is us handing in our luggage to be briefly looked after so that we could go get the badges. We also met a Swedish guy along the way and chatted with him during this process.
I'm on a boat, bitch. This do be Erin.
Hiya.
When in Cannes.
People are looking.
Yeah.
Can we go in this place? I'm glad you're right.
Ooh.
It looks posh.
It does.
We're living our best posh life.
Oh, maman.
Oh,
it's okay. Woo. Steak and shake. Have you got your shake?
No.
We visited the shop in the main building where most screenings and big premieres take place. It's called the Palais de Festival, and that's where we saw a bunch of merch and these handprints of famous filmmakers and film stars.
Whoa! How many pictures do you think they're going to put up of Leonardo DiCaprio? They really do. Oh, that's E.T.
She's in the main entrance the just for the shits and gigs.
They're playing the music to The Godfather.
I've never watched The Godfather. I'm sorry.
Oh, it's so good. Not to be basic, but look how hot it is. Francis Ford Coppola. Studios. It's a virtual production.
This place was really cool. They were showing us this new technology they're using for digital backdrops that will soon be replacing the basic green screen. The company are based in Soho in London, and they said that they've already been using the technology in films like The Batman and new Disney and Marvel projects, but they also want to make it accessible for lower budget projects. Also, as we were leaving, I noticed Sally Phillips and another famous British actress whose name I can't remember was there. So that's the picture of them that I managed to snag.
My dad has one of these. Some piece of tech, and he was like, fuck yeah.
Speaking,
me when I'm a TV. Me when I'm a gamer. My gamer chair. Boop, 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 boop. I can.
Can you?
Yeah.
Read my tap dance.
I can teach you.
Can you?
Yeah.
Oh, let's do it.
Should we do some tap dancing? Tap, tap, do.
I'm just sitting there. Is it comfy?
It's quite comfy. For a gamer chair, it's quite good. Funny story behind this selfie that we took at the main red carpet. As we were taking this picture, a man shoved his camera into our faces and a woman beside him started to say, "We are French TV and you need to take pictures like teenage girls if you want to be on our show, and we want you to, you know, you're teenage girls, you want to be celebrities." And she was like directing us of how to pout and make peace signs and stuff. It was hilarious. And so we had to snag a pic of them in return. As it was getting towards the evening, we went looking for some place to grab dinner, and we realised a premiere was taking place because of how busy the area had become. The premiere was for Les Amandiers, a film which we ended up watching the following day as our first screening in Cannes. One of the stars of the film was Louis Garrel, and so he was there and I was really excited because he's so cool. Oh my god, I love him. Probably the biggest star of the red carpet though was Sharon Stone. She was escorted by these two men in blue, like navy blue suits, and she had this amazing blue and white dress on, and everyone was just like in awe of her. It was crazy, everyone was just staring at her. She was amazing.
Foundation.
It was Louis Garrel, I was right. Nice!
At the restaurant, I asked the waiter if I could get my leftover pizza as takeaway, and his response was so cool. He was like, "Of course, I am French, forget about it!" And Erin and I found that so funny, it was amazing. As well as showing new films, the festival would also show some older ones on the beach every night. There's the queue of people waiting to snag their seats for that night. The morning after a film premiere is when the photo call, followed by a press conference, would take place for the film. On this day, the photo call was for Les Amandiers, and we were just killing time below the balcony as the photo call was taking place, before our screening of that film was to begin. We hung out with the paparazzi for a bit because they were also waiting below, hoping to snatch some pictures of the cast and the director. Past the yachts were a bunch of tents, each belonging to a different country, in an area called the International Village. Similar to the Olympic Village, I'd say. I think each one had press and like important film figures from each country in them. Nearby there was also a place where all the helicopters would land.
When two become one. I want to touch Sofia Coppola's hand. Oh, it fits. Here we have Quentin.
Bestie Quentin.
Here we have Sylvester Stallone. He was really separating his fingers here. Jack Nicholson. Sophia Loren. Such petite hands, Sophia. I have no clue what this one was.
Pringles?
Paul McCartney.
Pringle?
Meryl Streep. Look how nicely she wrote her name. I don't know who that one is. Who's this? I don't know who you are, Richard, and look, someone put the cigarette in there. Sorry, Richard.
As we were walking by here, I actually walked past Edgar Ramirez, which was quite surprising, but pleasant. Now, there was a midday premiere, so nothing too major, but this bestie turned up in her purple poofy fit and she came to slay. Unfortunately, I don't know who she is, and I don't think anyone else did, and there were basically no photographers there for her, so she just ended up posing for the tourists. It was a tad humiliating.
She does look great. Look how empty it is. But literally no one cares.
This was the funniest part. So this guy in a tux turned up and he had actual photographers that were interested in him, and the girlie was just in the background of all his pictures, so I think he pitied her and he brought her in to pose with him. It was kind of sweet, but also hilarious.
She'll just be in the background of his pictures.
Wait. Go back.
I think he just pissed her. So you want to see the camera? I think I'll have a frisky girl by my side. She would have been in the background of all those pictures anyway. It is. Throw in like the white and the yellow t-shirts. Minion core. I'm loving this.
To top it all off, the girlie in the tan skin tight dress proved exactly how hot Can is, with her little sweat stains underneath each butt cheek. It's absolutely adorable. I have no clue what was going on here. This guy was filming the poster for the festival whilst this other person sprayed red ink onto it, making it look like blood, I guess. It possibly was a protest to do with Ukraine or something like that, since a few of those had already happened at the festival, but honestly I have no clue. This is the press conference for the film that we will be watching soon, Les Amandiers. I'll be honest, I was only really filming it to get footage of Louis Garrel.
There he is. Third to the left, brooding. Dr. Smoke indeed. We're going to our first screening!
We watched Les Amandiers. The film definitely had its flaws, but in general was quite enjoyable, and anything with Louis Garrel immediately gets bonus points. I'll leave my letterbox in the description if you want to review. We rushed to get ready for the next screening at this cinema, which was a bit further away, so we had to take an Uber to get there. We got confused and thought the dress code was black tie when it wasn't, and we were very overdressed, but that was okay. The film we watched was Norwegian, and it was called Sick of Myself. And it was hands down the best thing that we ended up seeing in Cannes. It was amazing. It was really weird and also hilarious. We ate McDonald's for dinner, and on the way back to our hotel, accidentally interrupted a capoeira performance. The guy tapped us on our shoulders and we freaked out a little bit.
Can we just walk this way out? I thought it was you touching me. I freaked out. And then it's him. Guys. Oh my god.
just gorged about 500 grams worth of strawberries.
Delicioso. And now we are waiting.
Quite boring.
It is. How long do we have left here?
Between 30 and 45 minutes.
Okay, slow.
It's like a ride to Disneyland.
Oh, that is so true. Except it won't be 10 minutes long at the end. Yeah. It'll be a whole movie. There we go.
Fine. Just imagine you're stopping traffic.
So true.
We have a comfy car.
Next to the mud.
Go to the front, so it's unlikely we won't get in.
Yeah, we're at the front of the queue. It do be piling up back there. But yeah. But yeah. All is well.
The line we were queuing for was for the new David Cronenberg film that had premiered the night before, called Crimes of the Future, starring Viggo Mortensen, Lea Seydoux, and Kristen Stewart. The queuing was long, and at this point it was in the sun as well, and we can see the press conference in the background. It was fun eavesdropping on people's conversations though. A lot of people were in the film industry, so it was quite fascinating to hear them talk about it. Yes, Erin. Woo! We're actually going. Are we actually going to stand on that?
Will you take some photos?
Of course. This woman is doing a little report right here.
She's here on the red carpet.
Is she here on the red carpet?
I think she's here on the red carpet in Camden.
And then there's a photo call happening right there.
Look at Bessie in the new park. Show the sparkly suit guy. He's so cool.
Sparkly suit guy.
Back to you.
There are people coming in from the other side as well.
Don't be the OG. I am
Heath Lyon. Okay, now is our time.
It was so cool getting to walk up these stairs and to watch a film in the Theatre Lumiere. It's the main theatre in Cannes, and it's where all the big premieres happen.
So pretty.
It is. It's so air conditioned. Yeah, we were here so early.
What are you guys doing?
We
were
out
there making
niche. Well, they were out there doing niche. Look how big it is. It goes all the way down. But look at this though, my knees do be banging on the thing. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Articles and reviews. The TV station. And then the sea. Where do we need to? We need to go to a press conference. And we don't know where it is. It's somewhere in here.
Straight after the film was a press conference, and we went in with absolutely no idea about what it would be about or who would be attending. We were very surprised to see a bunch of famous directors, the most notable being Guillermo del Toro. It was actually hilarious how everyone in the room gasped and whipped out their cameras once he arrived. For over 2 hours, they debated the future of cinema, and to summarise, the old white men were all very traditional with their views, and often contradicted themselves by at one moment shitting on CGI and streaming services, the next minute praising films that use CGI and working with Netflix themselves. I did like some of the things they had to say, but overall it felt very self-indulgent and enforcing the fallacy of authorship in film, particularly the notion of the male genius artist. It was slay though, I did enjoy it. It's moments like these where I wish I spoke Spanish, because I wanted to talk to him, but I didn't know what to say, and all these people were chatting with him in Spanish, and I wish I could understand what they were on about. Please enjoy my goofy selfie with the legend himself.
Over there, they were doing interviews and stuff with some cool people. There's by the tents, that is. And then here, there are a bunch of restaurants.
By the
mound of sand. Okay, good. This is a restaurant, and this is Erin picking up
our menu that has fallen off. Okay, it's like, so this is our view as we dine. Not to be those girls, but we are somewhat those girls right now. Ha! These two are living out their Love Island fantasy. They were making out for a bit. Casa Amor. So right now there may or may not be a live performance by Maneskin. This could just be a recording, or they could actually be here. We don't know at this point. Can you hear it? Phone?
Oh.
Yeah.
Really?
Is that a live performance?
I think this is a live.
Wait, you can really hear the drums as well. Also, there are some lights that are flickering. Okay, so now it's raining, as you can see from the sky. You can hear the thunder. This do be, look at the clouds, jeez.
Shall we move the fucking?
We were planning on going to watch film there, but I don't know if that's gonna happen now. I'm waiting for another bit, because there was lightning as well. I'm waiting for that to strike again.
Should we skedaddle?
I should probably finish this.
We need to pay as well.
Yeah, that as well. Okay, so as you can see, it do be properly pissing down right now. When it rains, it fucking pours in Cannes, it seems.
Not the sandals.
Not, yeah, look at us. In the fucking sandals and our summer garbs. It was so funny. They had to pack everything up on this like beach restaurant thing so quickly. Action plans. Look how empty it is now. We had to quickly run to pay the bill and leave. Props could have not paid and run away, but we didn't because we're good people. And now what? We just sort of wait for the rain. I don't think it's gonna stop, not gonna lie. It do be properly pissing down right now.
Well then, should we
choose? It's soaking. It's just come. Oh shit! It's thunder, lightning, everything. Slip and slide. Slip and slide. We're trying to escape. Oh, this is disgusting. Poor shoes. So what, the film we were supposed to watch tonight on the beach, that's not happening. Gotta try and work something else out now. Head over the hotel. Fucking hell, it's freezing. It's so cold. Jeez. We're waiting to go queue up for another screening.
At Debussy.
At Debussy. Mm. And so, whilst we wait, we're just here by the pier. This girly do be having a photo shoot right now. Slay for her. And this is the view. These are some rocks that look like they're from Minecraft, don't they?
They do actually.
Cute. And here are people washing their yachts because they're redonkulously rich. I think some of these yachts actually belong to production companies.
Yeah.
Well, as opposed to people. Production. Yeah, Timeless Production. So they're all me when I'm washing, cleaning a yacht. Don't know how much they'd appreciate me filming them. Yeah, but look at these. Minecraft? Goofy shapes. There do be another yacht. The weather is, for me, ideal right now. It's like not too hot. Erin would prefer if it was a bit hotter. But I like it when I don't feel my skin peeling off. Mm. This do be the beach. Let's go to the beach. Beach, let's go get away. Yeah. Helicopter, helicopter. Well, there's quite a few people to greet them this time. It's not just one person. Oh, that would
make more sense.
Okay, first. Yoo-hoo! This is the village where pretty much every country has a little thing. I'm not entirely sure what they do, like press, I guess. Here do be the stalls and some more of the village. Then we get the restaurants on the beach.
Charlotte, look how blue they've gone.
These are Erin's shorts. I've gone blue because of the tote bag. Same thing happened to my hand. I don't think it's not too bad today. Wait, let's zoom out a bit.
It's fine, it's
It's not so bad today, but yesterday it was quite blue. Can you see? Nah, it's all right today actually. It's kind of come off. It's because it was raining and then the blue sort of seeped everywhere. Here the people from the film Dodo arrived for their photo call. Yay, we're doing this again, the rain. Day. Okay, he's serving. The love look. I love the guy's bow tie. He's so daffy. Ah, besties.
Oh, he's so fun. He's so up for it.
I was like, have I been cut off?
Liberation.
This was our first premiere screening and it was at the Debussy Theatre. The seats were amazing, so comfortable, and it made it very hard not to fall asleep.
Ont été soumis à la sélection et c'est pas 2000 films européens, c'est vraiment des choses qui viennent de partout, dont le Costa Rica, cet endroit du monde qu'on visitera également juste à côté au Panama dans le film de Claire Denis.
And I'm yelling, but that's what I do, don't worry about it. It is wonderful to be here. We are delighted to be here in front of you to present you our baby. We are very proud. This is the first time Costa Rica is represented in the official selection of Cannes. Not to bore you, I'm just gonna say that I want to dedicate this screening to the memory of Sergio Rojas and Jerry Rivera, who are two indigenous leaders that were murdered in Costa Rica because of their involvement in a land conflict, and the Costa Rican authorities rushed to close that case without finding anybody responsible. So I just would like this film to contribute to my country to address its problems of violence, injustice, and inequity, because like, if we don't talk about these things through art, then what are we doing? I hope you enjoy this screening. Thank you.
Algunas
Hola amigos, ¿cómo están? Un gusto estar hablando español acá, la verdad. Un aplauso para esta gente increíble, por favor. Un aplauso para Celeste Polimeni, Daniel Petris, Lorenzo Mora y Alberto Torres, el niño malalengua, que están aquí con nosotros. Merci Thierry, merci Kristen Jean. See you in a bit. Merci à tous.
Just came back from the screening.
I wonder
it was very slow. I fell asleep, so I've got an espresso now.
I have four new voicemails. Wait, is it maybe
I've never had one before.
Maybe it's from three.
This old lady was putting her meat into an ashtray for her dog to eat. It was really funny.
Okay, so as you can see, my hand is getting a bit blue because of the tote. I got one of these accidentally and then the pencil came and stabbed me through the leg. Popped. That's kind of slow. There's a premiere happening right now, so everyone's dressed in their garbs. We've walked away from that, but we also walked past Park Chan-wook in the process. So that was slow. And we also walked past this girlie that we saw at a photo call, so she's an actor.
And we also saw that really, really fit guy in the traditional dress.
Oh yeah, we saw some really fit people on the way.
He was hot as well, so he was taking a shower, and I wasn't mad.
No one was mad. We were pleased.
His tits were out.
his titties were out, and
get them titties out
because I gotta see him. Aim to the PM, double DM, and I need them. I really did need them. Those were great.
Yeah, I wanted them.
that was fun. We're trying to go to the queue for the Elvis premiere, so we have to dress up like 3 hours beforehand. Have a look, see what's in there. Well, we're covered slightly at the moment. But yeah, this is the only place where we can dress. Sorry, girl just squirted me, fucking hell. This is the only place where we can dress up like weirdos and not be weirdos. So we're in the queue right now, and look at this. Slug. This be the queue behind us of people. And in front of us, loads of people have been cutting in. It's kind of rude. Here's hoping we get in. Now the press are going in so that they can stand and take pictures. There they are. You can, where's my finger? It focuses on my finger. Can't do that. But anyway, yes, they go through security checks, the press. They go through the security checks where the tents are, and then they end up slightly behind the tents. You see that? Where all the cameras are.
Yeah.
One thing that made queuing up a lot more enjoyable was this blonde guy whose head keeps popping into the frame. He was French and just super duper cool, and he stood up for Erin and I twice when people tried to push in front of us. I had a mild crush on him. We got to watch from the queue as a bunch of celebrities started to roll in. The entire cast and crew for Elvis were there, plus celebrities like Kylie Minogue, Winnie Harlow, Conor McGregor, Kaya Gerber, Ricky Martin, Sharon Stone, Shakira, and Maneskin. After all that, we didn't manage to get in, but we were so very close to the front of the queue, and if people hadn't have pushed in, we would have definitely been able to have seen the film.
So we didn't get into the Elvis premiere, but here we are. Tequila Sunrise, Chardonnay, and Le Pain. So kind of slay. It do be what it is. Look at this. Look at that. Seafood risotto. Do be. Shit, man. Okay, well, this is a lot.
Louis, go out. Louis. Louis.
Okay, where do we be going?
Up and down.
up and round, up and round. We're going to the Agnes Varda cinema to watch a Louis Garrel movie.
Cheeky.
Cheeky indeed. Do you think, when will this film finish? If it started around like 7-ish, it could be finishing.
It's
and we
two
could...
hours and 49 minutes.
Oh, maybe it won't be finishing
so it's
yet.
It's nearly 3 hours.
If it finishes, so it'll finish around like 10 something.
Yeah.
Do you think we could possibly bump into them as they're leaving the theatre?
No.
Never mind.
We are going a different way. Party that they're at if you really want to know.
I don't know if I care for that. Our last screening in Cannes. I know, right? Not to be deep.
Whoa. Nearly stacked up these stairs.
Yo, 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 yo. Way downtown. The middle one seems to be taken, unless we go a bit further down. R.I.P. The Louis Garrel film was really good. It was a slay little rom-com. You liked?
I did like it. It was an honest to stand in the empty red carpet and take a photo.
I don't know if they'll let you stand on the empty red carpet and take a photo. It's been a long day, lads. And there do be parties going on around and about. We can hear things everywhere. Interesting stuff of the day.
There's so many birds in the sky.
Birds in, yeah, there are so many birds. Oh, you can't see it that well. But yeah, there do be tons of birds right now.
Little bird.
Me when I'm a bird. And I think we're going to McDonald's now, Slay. Look at this. We haven't seen this before. It says cocaine. Wait, I'm moving. So there you can see it.
Charlotte.
Cocaine. Cocaine.
Cocaine.
Me when I'm in cocaine. Mama McDonald's. Mama McDonald's. Jack Nicholson. I would just like to say, I don't know where the camera is, but I would just like to say that the nectarines, so good. The nectarines here are amazing. This is the last thing we're getting at Cannes before we leave. Sad times, but also sexy times. Look at this, Nutella. Oh, fuck yeah. This is our last walk around Cannes before we leave. Look how nice this stuff is. Ignore all the site, building site stuff. And the big billboard for TikTok. Besides that, it's pretty balconies. Hot weather, red carpets everywhere, even for breakfast. The cars like to stop for people most of the time. One time I did nearly get run over. But besides that, they do stop for everyone pretty much. Also, there's police everywhere and they all have machine guns on them, which is so nice of them. This is where we went to get our tickets in the first place and our complimentary poster.
Where are we going?
This way? To the yacht? The casino. If you walk down here past the casino, right next to the casino is the main theatres. Here we have the yachts. Are they gonna search our bags?
Yeah.
Why are they searching our bags? Okay, so we made it past the security check, which is very unnecessary. You don't see the point because it's literally just the road here. And then we walk past all the yachts. And then at the end, you often see paparazzi because that's where people have their photo calls and their little press conferences afterwards.
So.
It is quite busy, so maybe they are doing a photo call for the Elvis film. Curious. Okay, so there almost certainly is
an important photo call happening at the moment up there. On the balcony.
Look at all the paparazzi here.
The cars arrive around here, and then the people go up there for the photos, and then into the building for the press conference.
On our journey back, we eavesdropped on a conversation between two industry people who had spare tickets to the Elvis premiere and the after party, so if only we'd met them the day before, we would have been able to have gone in. They seemed quite elitist and stuck up to me. The woman said she'd never even sat through an entire film at the festival, and she just goes to get her photos taken in designer outfits. The guy talked about young and up-and-coming actors as if they were scum, and we ended up sitting next to him on the flight, and he overheard me mention Hugh Laurie, and so then he told us that he knew him or something like that. He's actually quite pleasant towards us.
So, that was Can. I hope you enjoy the video. Like and subscribe, all that jazz.